Hello everyone, thank you for coming up today. My old subscribers, thank you. And to those that are viewing for the first time or that have not subscribed, please click on the subscribe button and the notification bell so you get notified each time we upload a new video. And to my new subscribers, thank you for subscribing. Please do not forget to hit on the like button. This is a very big tragedy. A couple who just married, after 4 days, one of them have died. It was gathered that a 31-year-old woman, who is called Atejoy Veronica, has died 4 days after her wedding. And this happened in Edo State. But the woman is from Benue State, and right now, she has been buried. Veronica and her husband, whose name is Irabo Samuel, from Edo State, had their traditional and court weddings on June 25th and 26th respectively. She was said to have fallen sick on June 28th and died the following day, June 29th. This is terrible. Not just terrible, but it's a very painful news that has fallen on this family right now. Look at this woman who got married. You can see her there with her husband, looking very healthy and strong. All for her to fall ill. Just 3 days after her wedding, she fell ill and then she died. The remains of the marketing graduate was laid to rest in her hometown, in Gwe, local government area of Benue State. That's their wedding invitation which they had. It's difficult for the husband to even come to terms with the fact that the woman he just married 4 days later has now passed away. They didn't even get the time to live with each other. After getting married, immediately she fell ill and then she didn't even last for even a week. The woman has just gone. When you hear things like this, you ask the question, what really happened? A lot of people have gone to their Facebook to pay tribute to her because people are very shocked. Look at this woman. Looking at her, you can see that she is a very healthy, strong-looking woman. But right after her wedding, she just passed away. Someone wrote this on Facebook. Said it took her so long to realize that she has even gone. That God, you are indeed God alone. Rest in peace, friend. Veronica, you will remain in my heart. Good night, great administrator. Someone else wrote this. I woke up yesterday with the thought of calling you so we could see, since I couldn't stay till the end of the marriage ceremony last Friday. Then I heard very early that you passed away. How? Why? When? Just 3 days after your marriage? Then I prayed it was a joke, but it's not a joke. We became friends early 2012 during our ND days, and we continued to even BSc in the University of Agriculture, and from the period to yesterday that you left has been a difficult struggle. You had so many challenges in this journey of life. You even went insane after graduation and was struggling till God brought you to sanity again. And you went and served Nigeria, that's the NYSC, and returned. Joy, you just told me you wanted to further to MSc. And you bought the form just for you to resume school July. Joy, you had good intentions that you were so focused. Joy, you would have told me about the shock you gave me yesterday, as I usually called you. Shorty, life hasn't been fair to you, but I pray God show you mercy. Rest in peace. Amen, friend. A lot of tributes, a lot. Once you go to Facebook page, you see a lot of people have pay different tributes to her, her very close friends, family members, because a lot of people are in shock. There's a woman who just got married, has not even spent time with her husband, and then she has passed away. This is very painful. These are the kind of death that you just keep asking a question: why? What really happened? And okay, from all indication, her friend said she was actually insane at some point, and then she recovered. That she's been struggling with life. A lot of things had happened with her in the past, and now it's like she has come to her resting point. That is when she has gone. That's why this thing, death, is something that no one can predict. It's unpredictable. You can't really say when death will actually come. This man never knew that the woman he's marrying would not even stay with him for even up to a week. He never knew that they were not going to spend the rest of their lives together. And it's painful to hear that she has struggled for a very long time with a lot of things, and then coming out of what struggles she had gone through. And in the end, it's like she didn't even get to enjoy part of it at all. Alright, her friend even said she got the MSc that she was supposed to start her master's by this month. Now everything is just put to a halt, a stop completely, because the person is gone and will never come back again. This is the painful part of that, where the person has gone and you just remember that this person would never come back to the surface of the earth anymore. We need to be very prayerful. This woman, little did she know that she was going to die. She didn't know, her husband didn't know, friends did not know, nobody knew. You see someone and you feel that everything is okay with the person. Unknown to you that the person might be struggling with one thing or the other. Some people are just walking and then in their minds, they are off from their bodies completely. It only takes the grace of God for people to stand, and especially now that a lot of things are going wrong, things are really happening in a way that nobody even expects would be happening. You see, family is struggling. A lot of things have really happened terribly bad. A lot of people are not sleeping in peace. The economy has really gone bad. People are still trying to find themselves. You go and talk to some people now, they tell you that they are lost within themselves. They are lost and they don't even know what to do because of the way things have really changed these days. It only takes the grace of God for people to still stand strong and keep doing what they want to do in life. May the soul of Joy rest in peace, and may Almighty God console her husband, her entire family, friends, well-wishers, and everyone that knew her. It's such a pity that she has passed away so soon without even enjoying her marriage. So imagine the kind of suffering that she had gone through that made her go insane, and then now she just came out to come and relax, and to her it would look like she has come into the light where she would breathe in fresh air, rest, having her husband by her side. But unfortunately, she didn't get to enjoy that. That is one of the most painful ways someone would even die. And especially for someone who has gone through a very difficult time in life. And this thing of people, after getting married, they just pass away. A few days ago, I had posted another video of a man who just got married. A few days, he now passed away. He wasn't even sick, nothing, he just passed away. The other day, it was a guy who just got married. A week after his wedding, he decided to go on a trip. That was how him and his wife in that vehicle had an accident, and the guy died instantly. The wife is currently in the hospital receiving treatment. These are people who just got married 1 week. And some on their way to the place where they're going to have their traditional marriage, they had an accident. That was how the man passed away. The other day was a medical doctor who was preparing for his wedding. Just a week to his wedding, he was going for one of his calls. And that was how this guy had an accident. He died there instantly. Just a week to his wedding. The other day again, it was the Air Force officer who actually died in the plane crash just a week to his wedding. And that was where his bride-to-be had to marry his own brother. Because some people go through pain, serious pain, and sometimes in the midst of that pain, you try to find yourself. You try to make peace with yourself and with what is actually happening. A lot of people backlashed the brother of the guy for marrying the fiancé. They backlashed the fiancé. But come to terms with it, you wouldn't know what the lady is struggling with. Probably this is someone she has just fixed her mind on for the rest of her life. And for it to happen, she still wants to get herself in that home, knowing that it's like she is still marrying the guy. You wouldn't know what she's struggling with mentally. When people lose their loved ones, a lot of people struggle, not just physically, mentally, emotionally, otherwise. It's not easy for you to just accept your loved one leaving you. And when it's like you guys are trying to plan your life together, start life afresh, and then the person suddenly leaves your life, you can't just sit down and say, okay, the person has gone. It takes time. Those are wounds that take time to heal in the hearts of people. Because this is someone you're just getting to know, and this is someone you have decided that it's just him or her alone. And in the end, that doesn't happen. It's really devastating. Some people are even admitted in the hospital because of shock. Some people just collapse at that time. Some will slump and die. People have different ways of taking in pain. And so when people take actions in pain, in grief, you wouldn't blame them. They're just trying to find peace. They're trying to come to terms with the fact that this their loved one has gone, but he's still around. That's why you see that some of them will decide to still marry in that same family, so that it's like they are living their life with the person they have made up their minds to live their lives with. Just imagine someone that has said I do to a man or to a woman, and the next thing, few days, that person is not there again with you. It's really difficult to accept your loved one leaving. But what would you do? The person has gone. You can't change anything about it. Neither can you do anything about it. All you struggle with is how to heal the pain in your heart. Friends, isn't this very painful and very shocking, especially to the loved ones and to their family members? Looking at this lady now, she looks very strong. She looks very happy. But unfortunately, she didn't live to enjoy the peace and the love of marriage she actually wanted. And that's why sometimes they said, if you're out there with some people, you can never know what the person is going through. And you would never know the lifespan of this person. That is why it said, don't have disputes with people and then you want to engage yourself into physical fights. Some people, you will just hit them. You will hit them so hard. But just because of anger, you've hit that person. The person will fall down there and die. Unknown to you that either that person was sick or the person is going through something. Probably this woman was sick or she was going through something that even her husband or her friends or family were not aware of. Only her. Because for them to confirm that she actually fell ill just 2 days after her wedding. Fell ill and then the fourth day she died. But no one can really explain how the whole thing happened or when the sickness actually started. If she was ill a long time before the wedding, or did it just start a fresh sickness when she finished saying, I do. It's only her that can explain this, or her husband, if he had any clue at all. However any loved one leave the surface of the earth, it's still a great pain because you can never get to see this person for the rest of your life. When the person is gone and will never come back again. Once again, may the soul of Joy rest in peace. I pray that her husband will come to terms with it and let him find peace inside. It's not easy. It takes time, but definitely those wounds will heal one day. Friends, what do you think about this? There's a young lady who just got married. And 2 days after her wedding, she fell ill, and the fourth day she died. Although they didn't specify the kind of illness that she was going through that took her life the next day. That was really sudden. No one wished to lose their loved one, no matter when or how. No one will be happy to see their loved one leave them, because once they are gone, they are gone. You can never share those loving moments together again. You can never have time to express whatever you feel or what you think anymore. Although everybody will die someday, but how and when is what we don't know. And that's why we all keep praying and asking for God's protection upon our lives. Friends, thank you for coming up today. Please do not forget to hit on the like button, also subscribe and hit the notification bell so you get notified each time we upload a new video. Thank you. God bless you all.